I was on a photography workshop last weekend, and my teacher was talking to me about the exposure triangle, and it got me thinking about sleight of hand. And in sleight of hand, we also have what I like to now call as the sleight of hand triangle. Three things that make up a whole world of complexity and interesting outcomes of the deck of cards. We've got sense of touch, hand-eye coordination, and memory. So I thought it'd be interesting to share with you something. And if we have time, I'll put you through a little exercise as well. So first things first, I always work with a shuffle deck in use. So give the cards a quick shuffle, okay? That's very good. All right, I can see you're giving the cards the mathematician shuffle there, right?
There's a hole on the snap of my left.
All right, here we go. So, to begin, sense of touch. In a moment, I just want you to feel the edges, and with your thumb and fingertips, just cut off a small packet of cards, okay? Okay, very good. Do me a favor, go under the table, just feel the edges, and in your mind, don't say a word, in your mind, take a guess as to how many cards you think you might have, okay? But don't speak it out loud, and then count them and see how close you are, all right? This is quite interesting.
So it's actually bang on.
Don't say it out loud. If you've got a number in mind,
yeah.
How close were you?
Right on the number, funnily enough.
So you estimated the right number? Very good. All right. Pop your cards back. See, here's the interesting thing. You had to count the cards to be sure, okay?
Yes. Yeah.
Just from feeling the edges of the cards. What was the number?
15.
So you cut off 15 cards?
Yeah.
Watch. Just one second. Yes. Count them out loud.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15.
16. Off by one.
See,
this is interesting. We're dealing, was it 15 or 16?
It was 15.
It was 15, dead on. Okay, this is interesting. So we're dealing with the thickness of the playing card here.
Yeah.
You see that?
Yeah.
Okay. This time, lift off a packet, hold the cards close to your body. Okay. Now, pull the cards away from your body, look down, and see what cards you cut to. Alright, very good.
Right.
Now, I want you to hold the cards face down in your hand, take some off the top, place them underneath.
Underneath.
That's it, very good. Alright, and Vivian, I'm going to ask you to lift up a bunch of cards, and your pack goes in the middle, right there. And then go on top. Excellent. Now, let me share with you what I've just done. Do you remember I mentioned a moment ago, hand-eye coordination?
Yeah.
I was watching you to estimate your initial packet,
yeah.
And then you cut, so a certain number of cards went on top of the one you looked at, and then it went in the middle, so the cards that you placed on top now adds to the cards that you placed on top. This is really interesting. So now, if you notice, there are no bent corners, very smooth edge. I'm going to estimate the cut now, okay? What was the card?
Ace of clubs.
This one? See, this is the point. Sense of touch is useless unless you know what card you're going after. And this is the point. It allows you to target a specific card. So Vivian, this is for you now, okay? Take the cards in your own hands. I want you to deal the cards face down on the table. Stop whenever you like. Okay? Now, once you've stopped, give the rest of the cards a shuffle. Okay. This is a very interesting way of mixing the cards up. We're going to shuffle and deal, okay? And then throw down a bunch of cards on the table. Stop whenever you like, okay? Just throw down a bunch. Okay? Very good. Give the rest a shuffle. I think you'll agree, Douglas, this is an unconventional way of mixing the cards up.
Yeah.
But it does one very important thing. It guarantees randomness, okay?
Yes.
Are you happy with it? Okay, pop those on top. All right, here we go. Let's just square these up nice and neatly. Take these in your hand. All right. Throw down a bunch of cards. Would you like to leave it there or continue?
Continue.
Okay, throw down another bunch. Are you happy with that?
Yeah.
Do you want to continue or stop?
Stop.
Take the top card, stick it somewhere in the middle. In poker, this is called burning a card. And do the same with the bottom card. Remove the bottom card, stick it somewhere in the middle. Very good. Now place the packet on top at a funny angle. Very good. Right. We started off with sense of touch. Estimation is the term. We then showed you how estimation can be used to target a specific card. Now we're going to combine everything together with memory. Are you happy that it's been well mixed? All right, lift up the packet, hold it close to your body.
This is the top.
Yeah, this packet right here, lift it up. Okay, make sure you get all of them, okay? Close to your body. Look at the card you come to, remember it. Okay, put it back on top.
At an angle.
Let's square them up. Very nice. Splendid. Now, shuffle the cards. What's interesting now is you've got a card in mind. We've introduced shuffling into the equation. So this means one thing. I've got to memorize the cards now, okay? So just bear with me one second. I'm just scanning the whole deck. Okay. What was your card? Ten of clubs? Jack of clubs, nine of hearts. Your ten of clubs is in between the jack of clubs and the nine of hearts. So I could cut to the right to the jack of clubs, and this one will be yours. But underneath is the nine of hearts. Isn't that interesting?
Yeah.
Rather than cut, I'm going to try this with one finger. Digital dexterity, okay? It's a very fine art, this. Here we go.
Good to know.
Jack of clubs. I said the next one would be the ten of clubs, but I also said the one after would be the nine of hearts, right?
Yeah.
And you said ten of clubs. Take a look. Did you like that?
Yeah.
All right. Now, for this final piece, I want to try something that I think will be interesting for you. I noticed when you were shuffling.
Sorry. Not very well.
What was interesting for me was it was a good shuffle because it relied on the classic haymow shuffle overhand style. So what's interesting now is I asked you to cut off a packet. You estimated 15 cards, right?
Yeah.
Watch this. I'm going to ask you to cut off another packet, okay? A smallish packet. Go ahead. Okay. How many cards do you think you're holding there? Okay, put them down. Hold on. Let's just spread them out and see how you did, okay?
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7.
Oh my goodness. Do you know why he's getting it right? He's a mathematician. Believe it or not, your fingertips are now tuned in to 8 cards, so do you think you can cut off another packet? Same size. How many do you think you got now? How many?
10.
Let's spread them out. Spread them out. Let's have a look. Makes it easier to see. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. Okay, so from 8, so we've got a few more added. All right, let's try this. I'm going to desensitize your fingertips now. How many cards do you think you're holding?
12. I can work them out.
I'm estimating about half the deck there, give or take.
Less than that.
More than. You're probably right. I'm going to trust your mathematician instincts. Cut off a small packet right here. Okay. And cut off another one. All right, I'll leave that one there, okay? All right. I just wanted to desensitize your fingertips, okay? Take these. And now cut off one more pile right here. Let's see how well you did. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Wow, look at this. So 8, 14, 10. Isn't that interesting? All right, now last one. Cut another packet. And place these on the top at a funny angle. Now, you know what's interesting? estimating specific numbers is not the point. You've already seen. It's about understanding which card lies at a specific location in the deck. So if you were a skilled mechanic or a skilled mechanic with mathematical intuition and you knew which card was, say, 8 cards away or maybe 14 cards away or 8 cards away, and you had the skill, you could target in on those specific locations and give yourself a favorable advantage. Do you play cards at all?
Not very often.
Not really? Well, this is interesting. I mean, given the fact that the deck's been shuffled, I'd be interested to see what cards you've got to right now. Take a look.
Just on this card.
Well, that's not bad, isn't it?
No.
Pocket aces?
Oh, jeez.
And this one, just take a look. Cut, lift up the packet. What card did you cut to?
That's amazing.
Well, that says it all, doesn't it? Is this something you're not telling me?